Welcome. Adios Accent was made to improve the Spanish accent in English. Pronunciation is one of the hardest areas to learn in English because some letters have several sounds, especially the vowels. In Spanish, the letters are always said the same way. For example, the Spanish A is always A. This program has isolated 20 areas that Spanish speakers have problems in when speaking English. First, I will identify them and give their correct pronunciation. Next, I will explain why these sounds are difficult. Then I will show conversations in English. After all 20 problems are covered, there is a contrast section to highlight every sound. Finally, practice sentences are given for reinforcement. I hope that you will benefit from hearing and seeing standard American English pronunciation. Now let's begin. The short A sound. The short A sound is made by opening the mouth wide. The teeth are apart with some of the top and bottom front teeth shown. The sides of the tongue touch the bottom back teeth. Some English words that have the short A sound are family, cat, action, and plant. Hear the A sound? Now listen to the difference in the way the A sounds in Spanish. Familia, gato, acción, and planta. Because A is not a sound in Spanish, many Spanish speakers substitute the Spanish A, A, when speaking English. For example, pronouncing family as family. Notice the way Carlos pronounces the A in the following conversation. Then listen to his correction. Hi, are you busy today?
Hi, I have many parts to pack.
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 The D sound. D. The D sound is made by opening the mouth and lowering the bottom lip. The teeth are slightly apart, with more of the bottom than the top front teeth shown. The tip of the tongue touches the top of the mouth. The D sound, D, is often pronounced as a TH, the sound by Spanish speakers, because that is how the D sounds in Spanish. Listen to the same English and Spanish words and note the difference in the way the D is pronounced. Idea, idea. President, presidente, debt, deuda, and dance, danza. In the next situation, you can hear the accent in the word deposit. Should we go to the bank today?
Well, we only have one deposit.
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 The short E sound. The short E sound is made by opening the mouth medium wide. The teeth are slightly apart, with some of the top and bottom front teeth shown. The sides of the tongue barely touch the bottom back teeth. There is no short E sound, in Spanish, so naturally Spanish speakers will say the Spanish E, A. Here are some equivalent words in which the English short E and the Spanish E can be heard. Metal, metal. Sensible, sensible. Epic, épica. And the name Ellen is Elena. The short E in English is very light, eh. But in Spanish, the mouth is open wider, eh. Watch how strong the E sounds in the next situation. Are you feeling better now?
I still have a sore leg.
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 The soft G sound. G. The soft G sound is made by opening the mouth and pushing the lips forward. The teeth are shown clenched together. The tip of the tongue touches the top of the mouth. In English, the soft G sound is pronounced just like the J, J. Words beginning with soft G are giant, genius, and gymnastics. Spanish speakers sometimes say this letter as an H, H, because that's the way it's pronounced in Spanish. For example, gigante, genio, and gimnasia. Listen for the soft G with a Spanish accent and then hear it said right. For what position are you applying?
I prefer a job in accounting, but I will do office work in general.
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 The voiced H sound. Ha. The H sound is made by opening the mouth medium wide. The teeth are apart, with some of the top and bottom front teeth shown. The tongue is in the middle of the mouth. Air is blown through quickly. H in English is not usually silent. It sounds like exhaling air. Listen for this sound in these words: hungry, hero, and history. In Spanish, the letter H by itself is silent. Therefore, some people don't pronounce it at all. The Spanish translation of those H words is hambre, héroe, and historia. In the next conversation, Patty leaves out the H. Are you coming into the office this weekend?
No, but I will work at home.
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 The short I sound. Eh. The short I sound is made by opening the mouth medium wide. The teeth are slightly apart, with more of the bottom than the top front teeth shown. The tongue touches all of the bottom teeth. Here's another sound which doesn't exist in Spanish. Eh. The short I sound. Some English words with short I are rich, figure, limit, and impact. In Spanish, hear how the I is pronounced in the same words: rico, figura, limite, and impacto. Since there isn't the short I, Spanish speakers will tend to substitute the Spanish I. In the situation coming up, Carlos says 50 instead of 50. How many boxes have you packed already?
It must be about 50.
50.
50.
The J sound. J. The J sound is made by opening the mouth and pushing the lips outward. The teeth are shown clenched together. The tip of the tongue touches the top of the mouth. The English J, J, is sometimes pronounced as a Y, Y, by Spanish speakers. I don't know why this is, because the J in Spanish is more like an H, J, as in jefe. Still, for some reason it is. For example, the English word jealous is often heard as yelis by Spanish speakers. Job is job, and jump is often heard as yump. Hear what Anna is saying. Would you like more tea, coffee, anything else?
I would really like some juice.
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 The final M sound. Mmm. The M sound is made by tightly closing the mouth. The teeth, gently biting down on the lips, are not shown. The tongue is in the middle of the mouth. Another mispronunciation in English is the final M sound. Spanish speakers will often say an NG at the end of words ending in M. For example, I have heard the word time pronounced as tang. Other words in English are them, rhythm, and him. This may be because there are no words in Spanish ending in M that I can think of. Listen to Carlos pronouncing the word him. He says it as hing. Has Mike been here yet?
No, nobody has seen him.
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 The short O sound. Ah. The short O sound is made by opening the mouth wide. The teeth are apart with some of the top and bottom front teeth shown. The tongue is in the middle of the mouth. Short O words are office, obvious, model, and comic. Hear the ah. In Spanish, that same sound is made with an A, such as in the words algo and falta. It's the same sound. Now listen to the Spanish O. Oficina, obvio, modelo, and cómico. Hear the difference? When trying to pronounce the short O in English, just use the Spanish A, not the Spanish O. Here's Patty with a short O word. Did the telephone ring while I was at lunch?
You rang a load.
Lot.
Lot.
The initial R sound. Raw. The R sound is made by opening the mouth and pushing the lips outward to form an oval while gently biting their edges. The teeth are slightly apart with more of the top than the bottom front teeth shown. The tongue is in the middle of the mouth. When words in Spanish begin with an R, such as radio, respeto, and roca, the Spanish R is rolled, rrr. So frequently Spanish speakers will roll the initial R in English. Listen to these English words, radio, respect, and rock. Now hear Julian pronounce an R word, a word beginning with R. Do you have a pen?
Well, I have two. One is black, one is red.
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 The R sound. Raw. The R sound is made by opening the mouth and pushing the lips outward to form an oval while gently biting their edges. The teeth are slightly apart with more of the top than the bottom front teeth shown. The tongue is in the middle of the mouth. The R in English is pronounced as ra, as in the word serious. But in Spanish, it's said like a D, as in serio. So many Spanish speakers will say the R like a D in English. Listen to these similar English and Spanish words. Grand in English, grande in Spanish. Different in English, diferente in Spanish. Trumpet, trompeta. Listen to how Carlos says the word material. Do you have everything you need for next week's order?
Well, George said he would order the material.
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 The initial S sound. The S sound is made by opening the mouth medium wide. The teeth are shown clenched together. The tongue touches all of the bottom teeth. Air is blown through slowly. Many Spanish words begin with ES when their English counterparts just begin with an S. For example, the English word space is espacio in Spanish. Therefore, many Spanish speakers will put an ES in front of an English word that begins with only an S. Here are some English words. Special, stamp, and state. Now think of the Spanish equivalent. They all begin with ES. Notice Ana's common accent. Are you very busy these days?
No, now that I am done going to school.
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 The S sound. S. The S sound is made by opening the mouth medium wide. The teeth are shown clenched together. The tongue touches all of the bottom teeth. Air is blown through slowly. This next problem does not happen very frequently, and we weren't going to include it in this program, but since it happens enough, we thought we'd throw it in. Sometimes Spanish speakers say the S in English as like a TH sound. I don't know why this is. Maybe because some of the S sounds in Spanish, the S, the C, and the Z, can have a slight TH sound. For example, como está, or the way this people in Spain say the word C or Z, like zapata is zapata. So in English, it's carried over. I've heard people say something or thentable. Here's some English words: sensible, sap, sky, and social. All of those I've heard Spanish speakers say with a TH. Listen to Julian with a common mix-up.
Can I ask you something?
Something.
Something.
The short U sound. The short U sound is made by opening the mouth and lowering the bottom lip a bit. The teeth are slightly apart, with more of the bottom than the top front teeth shown. The tongue is in the middle of the mouth. Short U, is not a sound in Spanish. This is why Spanish speakers sometimes pronounce it like the Spanish U, ooh. Listen to the difference in the English than the Spanish U. Bust, busto. Number, número. And the name Augustine, Agustín. For the short U in English, open the mouth more. Say number, not number. Pay attention to Anna's short U word. I'm so glad you found your ring.
Well, I was very lucky.
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 The V sound. The V sound is made by closing the mouth almost all the way. The top teeth are shown biting down on the lower lip. The tongue is in the middle of the mouth. In Spanish, the V is more like a B, so Spanish speakers will often say words in English that begin with a V or have a V in them as a B. Here are some English and Spanish words. Hear the difference. Vocal. Vocal, cave, cueva, devotion, devoción. Now, Carlos. You look a little tired, Carlos.
Yes, I really need a vacation.
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 The Y sound. Yeah. The Y sound is made by opening the mouth medium wide. The teeth are slightly apart, with some of the top and bottom front teeth shown. The sides of the tongue touch the top back teeth. Just like the J is pronounced as Y by some Spanish speakers, Y is often said as J. They get mixed up. An example is the word yes. Spanish speakers will often say yes. Other Y words are you, not ju, and beyond, not beyond. Now Patty gives one of the most commonly mispronounced words. When was the accountant supposed to come?
Yesterday.
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 The Z sound. Zzz. The Z sound is made by opening the mouth medium wide. The teeth are shown clenched together. The tongue touches all of the top teeth. The Z sound, Z, in Spanish is pronounced like an S, S. That's why many Spanish speakers will say it this way in English. For instance, the English word lazy is perezoso in Spanish, so it will be said as lazy by Spanish speakers. Listen to the Z sound. Zipper, dizzy, jazz, and zebra. Next, Carlos says a number. Is it English or Spanish? What is the order number?
5-5-3-4-0.
0.
0.
The SH sound. The SH sound is made by opening the mouth and pushing the lips outward. The teeth are shown clenched together. The sides of the tongue touch the top back teeth. Air is blown through slowly. There is no SH sound, sh, in Spanish. So Spanish speakers will often say this like a CH, ch. Listen to the following SH words and how they're mispronounced in Spanish. Shadow is often said as chado. Cash, not cotch. Usher, not utcher. And she, not chi. Note the SH sound in the following situation. Have you ever worked overnight?
No, but last year I worked second shift.
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 The TH sound. The TH sound is made by opening the mouth medium wide. The teeth are apart with only some of the top front teeth shown. The tongue sticks out of the mouth between the top and bottom front teeth. Air is blown through slowly. Since TH is not a definite sound in Spanish, people will often say it as a D or a T. The TH sound is made by putting the tongue between the teeth. Listen to the following words. Thanks, those, month, and bother. Watch how Anna says birthday and then how she corrects it. How old is your daughter now?
She will be 4 next week on her birthday.
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 The past tense ED sound. Duh. The past tense ED sound is made by opening the mouth and lowering the bottom lip. The teeth are slightly apart, with more of the bottom than the top front teeth shown. The tip of the tongue touches the top of the mouth. In English, when we are talking about the past, we usually add an ED to the end of the verb. For example, today I cook, yesterday I cooked. For most verbs, we had this ED to their ends, but we pronounce it as the same syllable. Only for verbs that end in D or T do we add a second syllable for the ED. Like the word want, today I want, yesterday I wanted. We have to do that because it's the same sound. But usually, if the word doesn't end in a D or T sound, it's the same syllable. Spanish speakers often make this a separate syllable. So, for example, our words care, the past tense is cared, not cared. Hope, not hoped. Walk, the past tense is walked, not walked. And play is played in the past, not played. I can't find the budget.
It's in the report I type.
Typed.
Typed.
Contrasts. Short A, A. Spanish A, ah. Al, all. Cat, caught. Pal, Paul. Action, auction. Tack, talk. D, duh. TH, the. Day, they. Doze, those. Bade, bathe. Dan, than. Wordy, worthy. Short E, a. Spanish E, a. Sell, sail. Bet, bait. Red, raid. Pen, pain. Met, mate. Soft G, j. H, huh. G, he. German, Herman. Jolly, holly. Jog, hog. Jam, ham. Voiced H, huh. Silent. Hand, and. Hitch, itch. Hear, ear. Hedge, edge. His, is. Short I, Spanish I, e. Fit, feet. Ill, eel. Fist, feast. Dim, deem. Hit, heat. J, j. Y, y. Jet, yet. Jello, yellow. Jot, yacht. Jack, yak. Jam, yam. Final M, mm. NG, ng. Dim, ding. Ram, rang. Ham, hang. Some, sung. Brim, bring. Short O, ah. Spanish O, oh. Not, note. On, own. Sock, soak. Rod, road. Doll, dole. Initial R, R. Spanish R, R. Rich, rico. Rome, Roma. Real, real. Reason, razón. Rose, rosa. R, R. D, D. Red, dead. Roar, door. Reap, deep. Rug, dug. Rare, dare. Initial S, S. ES, S. State, estado. School, escuela. Style, estilo. Student, estudiante. Special, especial. S, s. Th, th. Sing, thing. Sank, thank. Saw, thaw. Pass, path. Sick, thick. Short U, ah. Spanish U, ooh. Tub, tube. Plum, plume. Rust, roost. Duck, duke. Mutt, moot. V, v. B, ba. Vote, boat. Vend, bend. Vat, bat. Dove, dub. Vase, base. Y, y, j, j. Yoke, joke. Yak, jack. Yawn, john. Year, jeer. Yule, jewel. Z, Z, S, S. Zone, Sona. Zero, Cero. Stanza, Estancia. Prize, Presa. Breeze, Brisa. SH, Sh. CH, Ch. Shin, Chin. Shore, Chore. Mush, Much. Share, Chair. Marsh, Merch. TH, D, D, or T, T. Sloth, Slot. Thrift, Drift. Theft, Deft. Both, Boat. 30, Dirty. Present tense, past tense, ed. Play, played. Smile, smiled. Trap, trapped. Call, called. Press, pressed. Practice sentences. Short A, ah. Anne has packed the hat that has a black stamp saying, Happy Travels. D, duh. Doesn't Dara send orders during the day, Monday through Friday? Short E, ah. Everyone met Ken and Becky yesterday at an expensive restaurant. Soft G, J. In general, the gymnasts gyrated on spongy mats in the garage. Voiced H. How can Harold have a hard heart when he doesn't harbor hostile feelings? Short I, eh. Is this the thinnest pin which Miss Smith could give him? J, j. The janitor just joked about the junk from January until June. Final M, mm. Tom put the blame on them because they came home to get him. Short O, ah. On the stovetop is a pot of hot chocolate we got at the shop. Initial R, R. The rest of Rick's reports were ruined in the room raid. R, R. Francis, Adrian, and Henry are three of the most caring brothers around. Initial S, S. Sister Sarah says that the scouts will scrub the school sinks on Saturday. S, S. So, is this the last test of the school semester, Sam? Short U, ah. We had fun running up the hill until a bunch of bugs started to bite us. V, V. Vowels are very hard to pronounce because every one of the five varies. Y, Y. You expect an egg to have a yellow yolk, yet my egg yesterday was orange. Z, Z. Zachary was lazy and didn't bother to zipper his jacket in the breeze. SH, SH. Shall we show them the shiny dishes we bought at the shop Thursday? TH, Beth's brothers kept themselves thin because they think this is good for their health. Past tense ed. Yesterday, I shopped, baked, cleaned, and played with my dog. Hints for improving English pronunciation. Talk with native English speakers. Get out there and talk. Tell your English-speaking friends that you want to improve your accent, so they shouldn't be afraid to correct you in conversation. Listen to their speech patterns and try to imitate the sound and rhythm of the words. Don't be shy. Practice is the best way to improve pronunciation. Watch television, especially the news. Newscasters are trained to speak clearly and slowly, making it possible to hear all of the words they use, even if you don't understand some of the vocabulary. Also, many of them have spent years perfecting the standard American accent, so you will be listening to a trained speaker. Listen to talk radio and audio tapes or speaking CDs. Without the distraction of moving images, sometimes it's easier to concentrate on the words being said and the tone of the speaker on the radio. Books on tape and talk CDs are good too. The readers usually take extra care to pronounce words correctly because they don't have any visual props to assist them. Tape record yourself. You may not realize that you are pronouncing some sounds with an accent until you actually hear yourself say the words. It is very helpful, if not a little awkward, to really listen to yourself. Use the dictionary. If you have trouble with certain sounds, like R, for example, go to that section of the dictionary and read all of the words starting with that letter. Repeating the difficult sound, one word after another, can help you to hear how you're mispronouncing it. Make visual aids. On a piece of paper or index card, write down a sound with which you have difficulty and at least three words containing that sound. Then, periodically glance over at the visual aid, and every time you look at it, say the words aloud. Try to write down at least one sound and its related words each week. Look in the mirror. Practice hard words in front of a handheld or bathroom mirror. Notice each sound in the word which gives you problems. Practice saying it over and over again, all the while looking at your mouth in the mirror. Notice how your mouth moves when saying it correctly. Try every technique you can to improve your pronunciation. Practice really does help. Those are the most common pronunciation problems that Spanish speakers have in English. I hope that this program has been helpful. Remember, the more you practice, the easier it gets. Our company, Vocalis, is dedicated to teaching English skills. If you are interested in finding out more about us, please go to our website, vocalisesl.com. We offer an array of English as a second language material. Another product of ours, ABC Pronunciary, teaches all of the sounds of American English. Thank you for listening. Best wishes in speaking clear English.